It's so good to see you all and to be back in the house. It's dope. As you all know, I traveled to California this past week, and we had an amazing time at the Gamer Conference / 23rd anniversary of Destiny Christian Center up in Victorville. It was amazing. Hopefully, you all got to watch it online on either Facebook or YouTube. If you didn't yet, the good news about technology, you can do so at any time. So I encourage you to go back and to watch all of the services, all of the things. You will be blessed. Okay, so our announcements are as follows. We encourage you to like, share, subscribe, and follow all the things on both our Facebook and our YouTube channels, both titled Overcomers in Christ Ministries. We're doing well on both platforms. And that's where we post any announcements or engagement posts. And unless previously told or noted, we will always be here Sunday at 10:30, Saturday 10 a.m., Wednesday 7 p.m., and then we'll always let you know if it's going to be canceled. So look there first and foremost. The next announcement is our prayer call, which is every Tuesday and Thursday morning at 7:30 a.m. You just dial 605-562-8401. The access code is 168-2332. Okay, and then on Saturday morning, you have another opportunity to pray, but this time it is in-house. And that is a glorious time of just prayer and fellowship with like-minded believers. The practicing believers is Pastor John likes to remind us that we are practicing believers. And so that's at 10 a.m. in person, or if you're unable to make it, you can use the same conference line as before. Next announcement is to invite at least 2 people per week to church. I don't know if you all have been doing it, but I know I have. I have 2 names that I put on the board back there. Yes. So, in particular, because of our church anniversary service that we're having on this Sunday, the 23rd. So, we want our confession of faith to be legit. We want every seat to be filled in every service with what? Expectations of signs, wonders, and miracles. And the only way that can happen is if we get the word out. If we be the church, go out and get the people, be a living witness, tell your testimony, bring the people in. The word says, with what will I draw people? With love and kindness. Are you being loving? Are you being kind? Are you showing yourself friendly? Amen. Okay. So, we should see the fruit. So, I already mentioned the pastor appreciation service on this Sunday, but again, it's this Sunday, the 23rd, 10:30 a.m. Okay. So you're invited. You know, all your family, your friends, all the things. Okay. And you can plan on being a blessing to Pastor John and Pastor Pat for all of their diligence and support and love throughout the course of this past year, because they do a lot for us. Okay. And we should. What is the scripture? Oh, yes, honor those who walk for our fault. Yes. Woo, it was in and out, but praise God. Y'all know the word. It's over time. Amen. We know that this is the time of the service. Well, you know, in other services, people say now is the time where we can all participate. But actually, every single part of the service used to be participating. You know how some people say, oh, I don't sing, so I just stand there. But if you were at a concert, would you not be singing? Right? Don't let your favorite song come on in the car, okay? So, how much more should we do for our Heavenly Father? Anyway, our ways to give are by texting 803-373-1878. You can text the word give if it's your first time. After you have set up an account, you can just text the dollar amount that you want to give, and it'll automatically go to our general tithe and offering fund. But in the training class, let me tell y'all what I learned today. All you have to do is, okay, for instance, the pastoral appreciation is coming up, right? So I created a form in Share Faith. If you just have to type in the word Pastor John and then a dollar amount and hit send in your text, and that amount goes right to Pastor John. I also did one for Pastor Pat. Isn't that good? Yes! And also, when we have outreach opportunities like Galatians 6 and 2, or when we do the Operation Christmas Box, you know, offering forms, and I'll let y'all know what the keyword is, then do amen. Isn't that a blessing? Yes! Like, come on, Jesus! You can also use Zelle using the email address oicm@gmail.com, or you can mail it to P.O. Box 491, Elgin, South Carolina, 29045. If you have, you may use the offering box in the bank. And also, once you have your offering, you may go ahead and rest on your feet and put your offering in your right hand. I also heard the bishop say, rest on your feet. Amen. You may rest on your feet, and let's go ahead and go before our Father. We thank you and we praise you tonight for another opportunity to give, another opportunity to sow into your kingdom. We are so grateful for just you being God and for how that you continue to bestow your grace and your favor and your mercy upon us, God. And Lord, tonight as we are sowing here at Overcomers in Christ Ministries, we know that we are sowing into good and fertile ground. And God, we are believing you for all the things that you have promised, all the promises that are in your word, Lord. All we have to do is read the word, find out what they are, and then ask them to believe. So, God, I thank you and I praise you in advance for what you're going to do with this offering tonight. In Jesus' name, I pray. Thank God. Amen and amen.
For Timothy, as the question, Psalms 91, verse 1 and 16. He that dwells in the secret place of the Most High shall abide under the shadow of the Almighty. I will say the Lord, who is my refuge and my fortress, my God, and him will I trust. Surely he shall deliver thee from the snare of the fowler and from the most high pestilence. He shall cover thee with his feathers, and on his wings shall be trust. This too shall be a shield and a shield. But I shall not be afraid for the terror by night, nor for the day that flies by day, nor for the pestilence that walketh in darkness, nor for the destruction that wasteth at noonday. A thousand shall fall at thy side, and 10,000 at thy right hand, but it shall not come nigh thee. Only with thy eyes shall I behold and see the reward of the wicked. Because thou hast made the Lord, which is my refuge, even the most high, thy habitation. There shall no evil befall thee, neither shall any plague come nigh thy dwelling. For he shall give his angels charge over thee, to keep thee in all thy ways. And it shall bear thee up in thy hands, lest thy death shall be the gift of sin. Thou shalt come on the lion and the leopard, the young lion and the dragon shall travel on the sea. Because he has set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will send my heart, because he has known my name. He shall call upon me, and I will answer him. I will be with him in trouble. I will deliver him, and will honor him. With long life will I satisfy him, and show him my salvation.
Amen. Go ahead and put your hands together for Pastor John. Hallelujah.
Say,
bring the word.
Praise God. God bless you all. Amen. It is an honor and a privilege to be in God's house just one more time. Anybody excited about that? Amen. God is good and all the time. Amen. Father, we give you glory, honor, and praise. God, because you're worthy, hallelujah. God, you spared our life. You see, this day, you woke us up with our life, our health, and our strength. And we take this time and say, Lord, we thank you. Hallelujah, hallelujah. God, we thank you, God, for those who pressed away, those who are tuned in. God, that you have a word, God, that will transform us, God, that will change us from the inside out. Give us the ear to hear what the Spirit is saying tonight. And we say, Holy Spirit, have your way in Jesus' name. Amen and amen. All right. Hallelujah. You may have your seats. Amen. Get your notes, your Bible, your pens and tablets, everything. Amen. Amen. It's an honor to be able to learn and keep learning more about our Lord and Savior. Amen. We honor Pastor Pat in her absence. Amen. What a word, Sunday. What a word. My Lord, my Lord. Woo! still excited. Even though I was away in the flesh, I was yet tuned in listening. That's my wife. Come on now. Amen. So we thank God for the word that Pastor Pat brought to us. Amen. You were here Sunday, weren't you? You were listening, weren't you? So from what is it, the Bible study review time. Question number one, what scripture did Pastor Pat take her text? What was her scripture? All right. Proverbs 18:21. Now here's an extra point, 2 points for you. What translation did she read? No. All right, did you remember the translation? She read the, I believe she read the King James, but she also used another translation. Let me help you out. She used the Message Bible. She said, words heal, words give life. They are either poison or fruit. You choose, my Lord. All right? Maybe you can redeem yourself with a true or false. Before a word comes out of your mouth, our mouth, we have already thought about it. Is that true or false? Let's give our people online time to type in. Before a word comes out of our mouth, we have already thought about it. True or false? True. That's a true statement. Amen. In Sunday's message, Pastor Pat told us, if we put the word if, I offended you. What happened? Let's give our audience, our online people time to type in some things. Amen. I know you know. That's why I'm just saying, all right, hold on for 1 second. Y'all remember that evidently. He says, if you have to put the word if in it or onto it, what does that mean? All right, what does it mean, y'all? Amen. It means it negates the ability of, yes, that word, of your apology. In other words, he says, it's not worth anything. Woo, he preached that. All right, let's keep going. I don't know who's here to declare, but we just, everybody's doing good again. According to the Message, again, this Sunday. Now, this is just something that you can personally answer. How can we apply killer thoughts and killer words? How can we apply that message to our daily lives? In other words, what did you get? What revelation? What impartation did you receive from Sunday's message? Amen. And just for extra credit, I don't think if you got anything out of it, it's not going to be wrong. Unless you're talking about the weather or something crazy, then we're going to say no, sister, no brother. All right, so what did you take away from it? How can we apply any part that God revealed to you? All right, no killer thoughts, and you won't have to worry about killer words. Anybody else? Amen. All right, she is saying we got to answer. If you think on those things that are lovely, just, honest, good report, amen, and true, amen, what comes out of your mouth would be lovely, honor, and good, all that. Philippians 4:8. I should have added that scripture so she could get a bonus. Amen. And one thing I wrote down, we should not be going around murdering one another with our thoughts, with our words, or through our texting. Uh-huh. That covers many of us. All right? True or false? We should choose to speak life to our situation, not death. Is that true or false? We should choose to speak life to our situation and not death. That's a true statement. Amen. Here's the bonus. You get this, you at the head of the class and you win, Sister Kato. Fill in the blank. Most often, God speaks to us through blank blank. Fill in the blank. Most often, God speaks to us through blank blank. All right, we may have to have a timeout and pause if you get this wrong. Amen, but I believe and have confidence that you know. What's the answer? His word. Amen. Amen. So I believe all of you got that. Praise the Lord. Amen. From Sunday's message. Amen. If you would open your Bible to St. John, the 6th chapter. Amen. St. John 6. And we're going to read in your hearing verse 63. Amen. But you probably have to read the whole chapter to get all of the history and background why Jesus said what he said. Amen. But we want to zoom in on verse 63. Amen. I'm going to read it from the King James, and then I'm going to read it from the Message Bible. Are you there? It says, "It is the Spirit that quickeneth. The flesh profiteth nothing. The words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life." Is it read in your Bible? What does that mean? Jesus is speaking. Let's hear it from the Message translation, St. John 6 and 63. It says, "The Spirit can make life. Fear, muscle, and willpower don't make anything happen. Every word I've spoken to you is a spirit word. And so it is life-making." Amen. And so is the word. Amen. You may have your seat in the presence of our life-changing King. Amen. Every word I've spoken to you is a spirit word. Amen. And so it is a life. It is life-making. I just want to share with you in continuation of what Pastor Pat shared with us on Sunday. Jesus is saying, "My words," this is our subject, "My words are spirit and life." My words are spirit and life. Amen. We learned Sunday that, as Sister Shayla has given in one of her answers, that we should choose our words, what? Carefully. Amen. As a believer, why is that important, Pastor John? Well, let me help you out. I'm going to use the same scripture Pastor Pat used, Proverbs 18 and 21. What does it say? "Death and life are in the power of the tongue, and they that love it shall eat the fruit thereof." And so, something happens when words come out of our mouth, and God is trying to tell us that we have to be ever so careful of the words that we say. And tonight he's saying, if you're going to speak my words are powerful. My words give life. They are spirit filled. Amen. And something has to happen when you speak and call on the name, the Word of God.
Amen.
So, what if, when you ask yourself, what have you been saying lately? What kind of words have been coming out of your mouth? Amen. Because if what we're saying and what we're confessing or even thinking, if it does not line up with God's Word, we are living, watch this, we are living a substandard life. What Pastor John, you mean as a believer, I can live a substandard life? Yes, because many times we operate in the flesh realm, and when the flesh is in control, we do fleshly things. Am I right about it? Amen. And so sometimes, even as Proverbs 18:21 says, death and life are in the power of the tongue. Many times we forget about speaking life, and all we speak is death. I ain't gonna have. I'm always broken. I ain't just happening. And that should not be the daily confession of a practicing believer. Amen. And so, listen, on this Christian journey, it's important for you and I to learn to say the same thing Jesus says to us through His Word. Are y'all getting this? So, again, I ask you, what have you been saying lately? Amen. What words have been coming out of your mouth? Amen. About your situation, about who you are. Because can I say this, even to be honest with you, there are some believers, practicing believers, who have a bad opinion about themselves. Amen. They don't see themselves as God sees them. And we have the mindset that, I'm just trying to make it. I'm just trying to survive. That's your old life. But when you learn what God says about you and you begin to take it in, and when it comes out of you, it's supposed to produce something, and it's called life. His Word is life-making. So if you want to change your persona, if you want to change who your perception about who you are, start speaking the Word, saying the same thing that God says about who you are. Y'all get this? My first point, I want to say the Spirit can make life. Amen. Jesus said, every word I've spoken to you is a spirit word. Are y'all getting this? And so it is life-making. See, we cannot expect to live this God kind of life operating only in the flesh realm. The flesh realm cannot produce nothing spiritual. And so we got to get past the flesh by getting more closer to God, getting in His Word. And the more His Word gets in us, that's what will be produced out from us. Amen. Listen, when that tree, that seed is planted, amen, it has to be nourished, cultivated. It has to be watered in order to produce a fruit. Am I right about it? If it happens in the natural, guess what? In the spirit realm, the same thing has to happen. Let the Word take root in your system, in your spirit, man. So when you water it, when you cultivate it, when you nourish it with the Word of God, it has to produce the fruit of the Spirit. Amen? So, you know, when somebody says, what's your occupation? It would be good to say, I am a fruit producer. Well, sister so-and-so, what are you producing? Because you look just kind of frail. It don't look like your hands are dirty. Don't look like you've been on your knees too much. So what? I'm producing the character, the fruit of the Spirit by the Holy Ghost in my life. That's why none of us can just stop and say, oh, I'm just saved. No, I'm saved, I'm sanctified, and filled with get happy by myself. Amen. It's the supernatural power of the Holy Ghost that enables us to live like Christ. I wonder if there anybody under the sound of my voice know what it means to pursue after Christ, pursue the Holy Spirit. I want more. We sing a song, I need more. I want more. You've got to get hungry. You've got to get thirsty for the Holy Spirit to dwell, to infill, to keep feeling, to overflow. Is there anybody that has gotten to the point where, God, I'm ready for overflow in my life? Part of the same mundane thing, going through the same motions, and don't feel the unction and the function of the Holy Ghost. You need to be filled with the Holy Ghost. Why is that important, Pastor John? I pray y'all listening tonight. Because it's through the working and wooing of the Holy Ghost that transforms us. Y'all know about that word, transforms us from death to life. Amen. Yes, no, we no longer operate on the death side. We are given life by the power of the Holy Ghost working in and through our lives. We are transformed from death to life, from weakness to strength, from pain to healing, from loss being lost to being found. Amen. The Bible is telling us we need the Holy Ghost on the inside to produce the character of Jesus Christ so that we, watch this, we can say what's right and think what's right. Oh, Lord. Amen. I just pray that somebody is really taking this here so that, amen, from this, we got a few more months left in 2022, and I'm sure that pandemic messed with some of our minds, some of the things that we were thinking, and as you turn on the news and turn on different social outlets, you're hearing some strange sounds, some strange things, people are compromising, seems like the people we thought were steadfast, unmovable, seem like they're changing their message, the approach to gospel is lukewarm at the best. And God gave me, if I don't shorten the day, he says, when no flesh be saved. It's because they're hearing another doctrine. They're giving their ears itching to hear another sound that is not sound doctrine. Be careful what you're listening to. Hallelujah. Amen. And so, in order for the Holy Ghost to transform itself, change the way we think. Amen. See, our minds have to be transformed before we can get our words right. Amen. Yeah, so when our mind has been transformed by the Holy Ghost in our conversation, our language, we begin to reflect what's happening on the inside. Then when somebody hears you ministering, hearing you talk in your conversation, you're like, you sound like us. You've been washed. You've been redeemed. You've been saved by the power of the Holy Ghost. And I just wonder if there's somebody in the process of being transformed. And first there must be a willing mind. Lord, work on me. If anybody said, Lord, I need, see, pride will keep you from a minute. I'm the one that needs that transformation. I'm okay. No. How you doing? I'm cool. No. You're not ready. God is looking for that one that said, I'm the one that needs that transformation. And when that transformation happens, I remember our late Apostle Bishop Hokum, he told us throughout the course of time, he says, learn to speak the word only. Woo! My God. He says, speak the word only. Why is that important? because the word is active and alive. Somebody has put that in practice before. Things are happening in your life and you just begin to speak the word. You begin to rehearse that word, mutter on it, meditate. Amen. And you found that your situation changed. And even if your situation didn't change, it changed you. It changed your mind. It changed what was coming out of your mouth. And when we allow the word to work, somebody say the word still works. Woo, my God. Amen. We allow God to intervene, and his word begins to transform that situation because he says it's life-making. Amen. And it's a spirit word because Jesus, watch this, y'all know this already, he is the word of God. Y'all knew that, didn't you? Well, let's see in the scripture, St. John, the first chapter. I pray that those who are listening, we thank God for you. Amen. This is a word church. Amen. We believe in sticking with the word of God. St. John, are you there? Chapter 1. Amen. Verse 1. It says, in the beginning was the word. Are you there? And the word was with God. And the word was God. That's a whole mouthful right there. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. Look at verse 4. In him was what? L-I-F-E, life. And the life was what? The light of men. Skip to verse 14. Y'all there? It says, and the word was made flesh and dwelt among us. And we beheld his glory, the glory as of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth. Amen. So when we speak the word, the word of God, we are speaking life, and we are speaking the spirit of God, amen, because it was Jesus that said, it is the spirit that quickens, that gives life, amen. You may be in some dead situations now, but God is telling us tonight, put the word on it. Why? Because the word has a tendency to bring dead things to life. Y'all gonna get that this week. Amen. If our dead things have to live at the mention of God's word. Watch this. Bodies are healed at the mention of God's word. Can I get one witness in the house? Situations are changed. Situations are altered. Situations are removed at the mention of God's word. Amen. See, one thing, if you've been in church a while and the word is in you, the devil is no match for the word of God. He can run, he can pass, but he cannot stand against the word of God. Woo! Yeah. If we want to experience the life-changing power of God in every area of our lives. Is there anybody here that says, I need some help in this area? I need the word. The God is telling us to speak the word of God in that area. What can I, how can I do that, Pastor God? You go through the word of God and you can begin to ask the Holy Spirit, lead me to the scriptures that can help me in this situation. Lead me to the scriptures that can speak to my soul. Speak to my spirit so that when that thing comes, when I'm faced with it, I want to say what you're saying on this situation. I don't want my opinion. I don't want the opinion of somebody else. I want to say the same thing that you're saying. Well, Pastor John, I have heard this all my life. And, you know, it must be God's will that I go do this. you know, my mama went through it. My sister, y'all just don't know how we did. And it looks like it's my turn now, and I don't want to be this way. You just keep on, you ain't the one yet. You got to grow into maturity. But if you sick and tired of the devil messing with your stuff and messing with your loved ones, okay, see, listen, the good news is it's just not for you. You can speak the word over somebody else's life, amen. And they may be going on and doing their own thing, but they don't know this. God got a prayer warrior. God got somebody that knows the power of prayer to speak the word of God. That's why when you don't know what to say, pray the word. All right, this is for old school folks. You ain't gonna hear this in no new popular church at all. People come to church now just to hear a sound. They're not coming for a deposit of the word of God. So you in the right place if you're coming. I want more word than I want the sound. But what you gonna stand on when the sound is gone? When the drums aren't playing and the organ and the tambourine's not going, what you gonna stand on then? Well, it sounded good, Pastor John. The devil can make music. Woo! And this music, y'all know about that. I ain't gotta tell you, it's not music that's gonna keep you. It's the word. And when you begin to speak, when you understand the value, the purpose and the power of God's word, you are cherishing. He won't sit in your car all week. Ooh, Lord, Pastor John, stop messing with us. You'll bring that Bible in the house because that's your daily bread. Some people are just living this life on spirit to spirit. They don't get filled up. They don't let the gas tank, the spiritual gas tank get full. Y'all know every time you go to the gas pump and you put $2 worth of gas. Where are you going? You might get down the road. That's the way some people act with their spiritual journey. I just want to get enough to put on down. How you doing? Well, my back hurt, my feet hurt, my head hurt. Got no job, got no money. Your testimony is not bringing glory to God. Something has to change. Again, I'm trying to do it in a thing where you can accept it. But our testimony got changed. How did the word reach you Sunday? I'm just getting you to say, I got to choose my thoughts. I got to choose my thoughts. It's a choice. And I'm going to practice it today. I'm going to practice it tomorrow. I'm going to practice it every day. And it becomes a habit. And now that I know, I want to help my sister who wasn't at church. I want to help my cousin and the one that just keeps all the time. Listen, set your mouth and learn to speak to her. All right, that's a little radical. I'm only talking to the ones that say I'm ready for change. His word, watch this, will work all the time. Why is that important? Because if the truth be told, many of us give up in the process of waiting. Yes. We don't want to wait on the miracle that God has. And see, in the process, if God gave it to you right when you asked for it, you just feel like he's a microwave God. But there's a process where, oh man, I had to wait on this thing. I had to cry, took a knife on this situation. And in the process, it looked like that's why we can't live this God kind of life going by what you see. We should go by what we see. That's offering time right there. Point number two, take God at his word. Boy, my time is running. Take God at his word. Numbers 23:19. Somebody needs to hear this tonight. God is not a man that he should what? lie, neither the Son of Man, that he should what? Repent. Has he said, and shall he not do it? Or has he spoken, and shall he not make it good? Woo! Woo! I can close the book right there. Amen. Amen. God is not like man. Amen. Because why is that? Because man has a tendency to change his mind at any given time. And I came to tell somebody, God does not change his mind. And his word does not change, watch this, with man's opinion. It's not changed because he's having a bad day. If he spoke it 2,000 years ago, guess what? It still works today. Amen. God's word is immutable. Y'all heard that before. That's one of the words, yes. God's word cannot change and will not change in any way, shape, or form. Why is that, Pastor John? Well, let's see what the word says in Psalm 119 and 89. Forever, O Lord, thy word is settled in heaven. Amen. In other words, you know what Jesus told Satan? He said, it is written. I came to tell somebody, if you have a Bible, it is written. Amen. In other words, what you read tonight is going to be the same thing you see when you come back same time next week. Woo! Amen. The word works. It's so powerful. Watch it. It has, I like this. This is off the top. So listen. The word has the ability, the divine ability, to produce whatever it talks about. It has the divine ability, because it's so powerful, to produce whatever it talks about. Amen. And listen, it goes beyond intellectual knowledge. It goes past all of your that kind of education. Amen. People say, well, I'm so educated, I don't need all of that word. It doesn't have anything to do with your intellect. Amen. God's word is so powerful. Amen. It can change your current situation. But we have to learn how to apply the word of God, because his word says what he says in his word, he will do. Whatever he promises, it shall come to pass. You know, one of the things, you know, we go through Christianity and you hear a lot of the older folks say, I know what prayer can do. I know what God's word can do. It's not just limited to the older folks, amen? Wouldn't it be powerful if our young folks start to testify, I put the word on my marriage, I put the word on my job situation, and God came through for me, amen? A lot of times we can testify, I don't know what my granddaddy, my grandmama, and cousins, and I don't know all the older folks, but why won't you make it a testimony for your are y'all listening? Amen. God still works. Amen. We must choose to believe God's word. Amen. Without wavering and without doubting. We choose to believe God's word. And after we choose to believe, amen, because it's a choice. Amen. Not only that, once we choose to believe God's word, we act on what we believe. Well, y'all remember the story of the lady that had the issue of blood. In the crowd, she was not supposed to be in the midst of the crowd. But the Bible says she said within herself, if I could just touch for him others from it. Y'all see where faith is coming along? I will be made whole. She could have stood there on the sidewalk until Jesus was in another town, but if she hadn't put question to what she was believing, she wouldn't have experienced her miracle. So in her believing, she said, my action is I got to get pressed my way through the crowd. There are some people in here under the sound of my voice that are listening. God is telling you, press your way through the noise. Press your way through the crowd. Press your way through barriers and blockages and get to Jesus. And so she put action to what she believed. Amen. And it was granted her. He said, woman, thy faith has made thee whole. And the disciples are looking around as anybody could have touched you. We're in a crowded situation. But Jesus knew there was a special place. Hallelujah. Amen. I want to have you touch the Lord. Amen. With your faith. Amen. And so we act on what we believe. And one of the ways how do we put access to what we're believing, you speak the word. You ain't got to climb no mountain. You ain't got to go ride and do town. Speak the word. Upon what you believe. You speak the word until you see the result that you believe God for. That's heavy right there. Keep speaking the word. You may have pain wrapped in your body, but you get up and say, God said, I'm healed. You get up and say, I am a millionaire, and you may not have two pennies to rub together. Promoted, and you probably got passed over two or three times, but God says, it's mine, and I'm standing on God's word. Promotion don't come from man, it comes from God. You find that in Psalm 75. Promotion don't come from man, it comes from God. Well, nobody here want to get promoted? All right, we just keep on going. All right, amen. I came to tell somebody, watch this. What you believe and not what you see. Y'all heard that tonight. He told us in St. Mark, the 11th chapter, verse 23, I believe it says, have faith in God. Amen. So we cannot heal our feet of faith by speaking negative words and negative thinking because we're not seeing immediate results. Why is that important? Is not the only day you should speak faith. You come to church, you're around the believers, oh, I'm on my way to heaven, and I'm so glad. And then Monday, I don't know if I'm good now. You see what I'm saying? If you should say it on Sunday, say it all week long. Say it every day. Because why is that? When God speaks to us through his word, nothing else matters. And can I tell you, sometimes in our speaking the word, in our waiting, in the process, it gets rough. And sometimes, I'll tell you the truth, sometimes it seems like it gets more difficult before we started speaking and believing. All right, I want to talk to the priest. Amen. But I came to tell somebody, you got to stay in the word. Can you shout that back at me? Stay. All right. And I'm going to give you the reason that I'm going home. Isaiah 55 and 11. I'm so excited this week that the rest of the week, amen, somebody's going to say, man, I'm going to pick up my word. I'm going to start saying what God says about me. Amen. Because this situation has been going on too long. Amen. And I knew what I should be doing, but God is affirming, God is confirming that I haven't been speaking the word enough. I've been putting my opinion on it, I've been putting my mouth on it, but I didn't put my word on it. Woo-hoo! Somebody get ready to experience a mental miracle. I'm not in the right church. Amen. Why is that? Why are you so excited, Pastor John? Because if you read in Isaiah 55 and 11, y'all there? It says, so shall my word be that goeth out of my mouth. Watch this. It shall not, isn't that in your Bible? Return unto me void, but it shall accomplish that which I please, and it shall prosper in the thing whereto I send it. In other words, he says, my word just don't go out and accomplish nothing. No, he says, my word will always produce results. Ooh. If you need a miracle, put the word on it. If you need something from the Lord, put the word on it. In other words, we can put God in remembrance of his word. Lord, you said. Has anybody had to pray one of those prayers? Lord, you said. God, in your word, you told me that I'm the head and not the tail. You said, I am the lender and not the borrower. Y'all remember the word, don't you? All right, I'm about done. My last point, I got to go. I got to tell you this and go home in 18 seconds. You will have what you say. Woo-hoo. Is that Bible? Well, if you look in St. Mark, the 11th chapter, verse 23, it says, for verily I say unto you, whosoever shall say unto this mountain, be thou removed, and be thou cast into the sea, and shall not doubt in his heart, but shall believe, watch this, here's the turnaround, but shall believe that those things which he saith, somebody shall say it, shall come to pass. Watch this, he shall have what whatsoever he says. Ooh. So the question is, what are you saying? What are you saying about your job situation? What are you saying about your finances? Are you saying what God says? Amen. What are you saying about your marriage? In every area that affects our life, what are you saying? We've got to remember it. Let us stand to our feet. Death and life are in the power of the tongue. Hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. We must hide the word in our heart. Amen. And apply it to our everyday life. Amen. And we can watch things turn around because we are speaking the word only. Close thy eyes closed. Father, we thank you for your word. God, telling us your word, God, is life-giving. Amen. Spirit-filled. Amen. It's able to transform, amen, our situation, our lives, our issues, oh God, if we would just learn to speak the word only, oh God. God, help us, God, to value what you're saying to us in this season, in this hour, oh God. God, every time we turn on the news, we hear, we see things are happening. But God, we stand on your word, oh God, that it shall not come nigh thee, oh God. Your word is filled with a power and the ability to make things come alive. And God, I thank you for a turnaround. God, this rest of the week, God, help us to be mindful of the words coming out of our mouth, God. Help us to take notice of what we're saying. God, not a mouth full of murmuring and complaining, but God, we exalt your name to your word, oh God. Oh God, and we thank you for the miracles, the unexpected things, oh God, that's coming our way, oh God. Give us an eternal expectation, oh God, that things are getting ready to turn in our favor. And Father, I thank you for that man and woman that's at the crossroad that says, I don't know about you, but I'm willing to give it a try. I've tried this, I've tried that. But now I submit and surrender my life to Jesus Christ. God, we welcome them with open arms, oh God. God, that they may come into the kingdom of light, oh God, turning their back on the kingdom of darkness. And God, walking in the newness of life. And we give you glory, honor, and praise. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. Come on, put your hands together. Hallelujah. My words are spirit and life. Amen. God is trying to tell us if we got to change our language, change our conversation, now is the time. Because some of us are our own worst enemy. You can't blame nobody else if your mouth is not lined up with the word of God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Let's do our benediction. Amen. Don't forget to invite somebody. Amen. We're looking for a high time in the Lord. Amen. Bring your shouting shoes. Not those ones that hurt your feet. I want some shouting shoes. All right, that's old school. And now may the grace of God, the love of God, and the sweet communion of the Holy Ghost rest, rule, and abide with you all. Both now and forever. Amen. Amen. Have a blessed rest of the week. Show some love to somebody in Jesus' name.